You're watching The American on ESPN from beautiful Dallas, Texas. It's the American Athletic Conference Women's Swimming and Diving Championships on ESPN. The beautiful Robson and Lindley Aquatic Center is the spot here in Dallas. And welcome in poolside along with former University of Texas swimmer Smacker Miles and Natalie Kalibat, the USC Pac-12 champion in diving. I'm John Liddle. Great to have you with us as well. This is going to be a lot of fun. The first of four nights of final events. Only three events tonight, but they mean so much, Smacker. We've got two relays, and that means big points.
We get to see the sprint medley, the sprinters of each of the strokes, and we get to see the distance free relay. So we're going to see whose tapers really hit, and it's a fun team start to the meet.
Absolutely. Meanwhile, Natalie, I know you've been watching these divers all day. Today, we get the 1 meter championship. What are you looking forward to seeing?
It's going to be exciting. FIU's Paige Burrell set a new meet record after prelims, and of course, she's facing the defending champion from SMU in Nicole Stambo. So it is going to be a battle.
Absolutely. A hot start to the night, and let's take a look at the preseason poll. Now, one of the notable absences is Houston, the eight-time defending champ of this league, Smacker, and so things are wide open coming into this weekend.
It almost feels interesting to even have a poll because Houston dominated for a while and they're no longer in the race. You feel like there's a lot of opportunity here. The coaches voted on this, so the coaches do tend to know best. And FIU got a lot of votes there, SMU second. But a lot of these coaches, when we talked to them this week, they were really excited to see their student athlete perform. And they were all very optimistic and felt like they had a much improved team, even since their midseason meets.
And remember, in 2023, Florida International did challenge Houston in this championship, only finished about 10 points behind. They were right there last year. Let's look at the event schedule tonight. We've got four straight nights of championship events, and on day one, it's the 200-yard medley relay. We'll start that out and then get the 1 meter diving, followed by the 800-yard freestyle relay. On one hand, Smacker, we're easing our way into it with only three events. On the other hand, you can tell how much this means to all of these teams, and they are so excited to get started tonight.
They're fun events, and they're events that each of these teams really focus on and in practice. With relays being double points, it's huge to start out on the right foot. Each of these sprinters leaning on their teammates and knowing what splits they need to put it together and score or podium in this event. So this is something that these teams have pointed at for a long time.
And it is interesting that Florida International, coming into today, does have the best times of any of the teams in both the 200-yard medley relay and the 800-yard freestyle relay. And here come the teams. The homestanding SMU Mustangs are there. Absolutely. What are these feelings like when you've worked all year, Smacker? A lot of times those early mornings and late nights with nobody in the Natatorium, and all of a sudden the fans are here, the families are here. You know this is what your season is riding on. What are these feelings?
Those nerves are what get you out of bed in the morning. Those nerves are what you get through you for tough weight sessions and long sets and tough sets and short rest sets. So this is a moment that they've all been excited about and pointed at since the offseason. And with the seedings, it doesn't always mean that it's going to be, you know, the middle of the pool is all that matters, because it depends on how much teams rested for their midseason meet, and not always predictable.
So the 200 medley relay, North Texas is in lane number one. And remember, these lanes are near side to far side. So North Texas, East Carolina, Florida Atlantic, Florida International, SMU, Rice, and Tulane. Florida International had the best time in the regular season, if you will, a 139.34. Backstroke first, then breaststroke, butterfly, and freestyle. Two laps per swimmer, and we are ready to go tonight. And we are underway. So for North Texas in the nearest lane, they are going with Noel Marsh, the junior, Florida Atlantic in lane number two, Dolores Margini. You've got Rice's Amelia Kane, a junior, in lane number three. Lane number four is Christy Chewy, who's a star for FIU in East Carolina, followed by SMU's Lucrezia Napolitano, and then two lanes, Victoria Raymond, just a freshman, but she has starred. What do you think about that first leg in the backstroke?
Strong leg, not a relay exchange, so the relay exchanges make a huge difference as far as the technical aspect of this race. It's one of the most fun events to watch. And John, just seeing you get out the lane assignments is quite the challenge with how fast this event moves.
Kaylee Turner of North Texas in one. Kasia Selick along with Shannon Campbell, Harley Cortois-Davies, Indra Vandenbush from SMU, and Andrea Zeebe, the sophomore. And now we are in to the butterfly. And that is FIU in the lead with Nicole Frank Rodriguez out in front in lane number four. As see about a half of a length with SMU trying to close in out of lane number six. And now we're finally into the freestyle. And this thing moves fast. Joy Graziano, Bri Belisle, Lily Cremo, Ana Luzia Desan, Jenna Watson, and Grace Dale. And here we come in the final as SMU is trying to make a charge. They're in lane number six. It's going to be right down to the wire. And who wins it? The SMU Mustangs finish in third. It is FIU at 22:39 in the split. And FIU takes it at 138.15, followed by SMU at 139.03. And then in third place, it is Rice at 138.19. Now it looks like Rice is in second. My apologies. So there you go. FIU, Rice, and SMU. That is what we saw there. And like you said, that one goes really, really fast. And FIU had the time advantage coming in at 139.34, and they finished more than a second better than that time here in this first event.
What a picturesque start to the meet. You see the sprinters, the straight arm from the flags in, and an unbelievable split by the Rice anchor, anchoring in 22.0, completely 22 flat. What an impressive split. And FIU holds on in the middle of the pool. What a fun start to the meet. Lots of different strokes, and a lot of times in this event, they're all within a couple tenths of each other. So you kind of expect a little bit of a lead change back and forth, but you also expect it to come down to the wire, and it did. So that event did not disappoint.
How impressive is shaving a second off your best time of the year for FIU?
That says that their second half of the season training really worked, and you figure a second is really 0.2 per swimmer.
Right.
So that's about on as far as what you would hope for, but they absolutely exceeded the expectation of as far as their seed time.
Meanwhile, Rice had a seed time of 141, and they swam a 138.19, so that knocked off more than 3 seconds. That's incredible for Rice.
That was a pleasant surprise as far if you're a Rice Owl. What a great outing and just a great start to the meet to have all four of your sprinters deliver that well. This event can kind of predict the sprints, the hundreds of each event, so we can look to have some Rice Owls in the middle lanes on 100 free, 100 fly, 100 back, and 100 breast.
Lily Kramer's time was just behind FAU's for one of the best times. In fact, looks like Lily Kramer's time as the anchor for Rice was at 22 flat, which ended up being the best split coming down the stretch on that final 25.
She was outstanding on the final leg of that relay, and if she anchors there 200 medley relay, she will likely anchor their 400 free relay and their 200 free relay. So that's an early indicator of Rice being really strong on the final leg of each of these relays.
So Florida International, Christy Chewy, along with Harley Cortois-Davies, Nicole Frank Rodriguez, and Ana Luisa Desan, they are able to take gold in this initial event. as we see all the fans that have lined up. It is absolutely packed in here tonight. And we're definitely feeling it this evening. Again, the FIU winners, Deanna Santa Maria, Christy Chewy, Umi Diop, and Jessica Shipico. And a great start for FIU, followed by Rice.
FIU won both of these events, the first night events last year. So if they could defend in the 800 free relay, they would defend both of their first place finishes on day one.
And that's exactly what they wanted to see, just an outstanding start to this event for Randy Horner, the 15th year head coach at Florida International, 8 consecutive Conference USA titles for Randy Horner. And now that the times have been verified, here are the top three. Florida International does go 139-34. And did we have a Rice DQ, perhaps? Because they've got SMU at 139-40 and then Florida Atlantic at 139-92.
The scoreboard could have been wrong.
It could have, absolutely.
So it was. We haven't gotten any word of anyone being DQ'd, so likely misinformation from the scoreboard, just a different lane assignment that was up.
And so we are getting a little bit of some clarification on exactly what happened. And on the live stats, Smacker, they do have Rice with no time DQ'd. Yes, and so with FIU, so we were right that on the scoreboard it did say FIU Rice SMU. However, it looks like an FIU SMU Florida Atlantic finish here with Rice DQ'd, and that is really tough to see after that quadrant put up an outstanding time for Rice.
The referees look at each exchange on each lane and know their assignments based on who they're supposed to look at, and there's also the ability based on the touch pads to see the amount of time between exchanges.
Right.
So with 3 relay exchanges in 8 different lanes, it's a lot to look at for you and I, John, but the referees get to see all of those exchanges up close, and anything, you know, negative is an auto DQ. So it could have been one of those 3 exchanges. And it's such a fine line between wanting to have a fast relay start and that being a total key of the event, but also not wanting to cut it too close. Most coaches will coach to being about 0.05 on your relay start. They don't actually want you at 0.01 or 0.02.
It's just kind of get too close.
Yes. If at some point it becomes no longer a visual. There's not like a visual lapse in time. So most coaches want that slight visual lapse so that there's no question that they don't ever have to actually go to the touch pads. So tricky and definitely easy to let your nerves get the best of you, especially on the first event of the weekend and an event where your team is counting on you even more so than what you feel like during an individual event. So that may have happened, but at some point the coaches will know which exchange it was.
But right now, it does appear like Rice was disqualified. So says the official word. So Florida International would get the 40 points here. SMU would bump up to second and pick up 34 points, followed by Florida Atlantic at 32 points. East Carolina finishing in fourth, North Texas in fifth, and Tulane finishing in sixth with Rice disqualified. So Florida Atlantic on the podium. That's got to feel good for the FAU swimmers. Making their way from Boca Raton, Riley Trout, Bulu Bianchi, along with Lauren Wright and Izzy Jones. A couple freshmen, one on the second leg and one on the freestyle leg as well.
with a finals time of 1:39.03. Silver medal for SMU. Your 2024 champions, a finals time 1:38.15. Gold for Diana Santa Maria, Christy Chewy, Omi Dia, and Jessica Spilko, Florida International.
So the Florida International Golden Panthers are champions and take the gold. Just getting off to that hot start, Smacker, with that 200 medley relay. Although it's, you know, only one event, one relay event, but getting off to the great start, especially when FIU said coming into the event they felt like they needed to be quote-unquote perfect, and that's what Randy Horner said, to take the championship. How well do you think that that makes the team feel as a whole?
This is one of those events that coaches plan their program around, in the sense that you're going to recruit a sprinter in every stroke, and you're going to recruit heavily to relays. So when your sprinters are on, that says a lot about a large majority of the events. So this first event and the teams on the podium is a huge indicator of who's going to be on the inside lanes the rest of the week. So this is a huge confidence booster to be on the podium with your teammates on night one. And we'll see how it plays out in the distance relay coming up.
Exactly. The 800-yard freestyle relay, which will be right after the diving event today. And that'll give some of these top contending teams like FIU and others a chance to put their mark on night number one. However, Florida International is your winner tonight in the 200-yard medley relay. And let's go down, and on the deck, we throw it down to Natalie. Go ahead.
You ladies are the defending champions, came in with confidence, and you get it done. How big of a deal is it to come in and start your championship off with a win?
It's just trying to stay confident, knowing that we've done the work and we have a whole team behind us. Everybody is supporting each other. We have a good energy. We're cheering every time, so bows up.
It was a total team effort. Jessica, SMU was really clawing at you there at the end, and you held it together. How did you get it done for your team?
I think feeling the whole team behind me, and I don't know, the cheering and the atmosphere in this pool is amazing, and I think that's what gave me the power to finish strong.
And you guys are focused. Your other teammates already warming down and getting ready for the next race. What's the focus heading into the next races?
So Christy have the 4x2, so she went to recover. But we're going to cheer for her for sure and the whole team, because I think we want to win again the 4x2. And we will see what will happen.
Awesome. Thanks, ladies, and good luck.
Thank you.
Back to you guys.
So Christy Chewy, the All-American, also a part of what FIU did on that particular event, and she's also going to be part of the 4x2 freestyle in just a little bit as well. Great start for the 305, and gold for FIU in the 200-meter relay. The medley, it was a lot of fun. It came right down to the wire, and we also see early on how heartbreaking it can be to come so close and then get disqualified as well, as Rice did after it seemed as though they had swam for silver. That didn't end up being the case.
John, how dare you set me up to talk about heartbreak of I mean, there's few things more painful than the tears that go on in the warm down when the race does not go as you envisioned it the entire season and all of the training. So it's a low moment for that relay, and I'm sure her teammates are there to pick her up. And really, they had a good event. Realistically, we're probably looking at less than a tenth in the time that they saved on the DQ.
So they're not getting the points, which is incredibly disappointing. But as far as an outstanding performance by them, it doesn't actually take away, you know, you take away negative 0.04 or whatever they were on that exchange, but it doesn't make a difference in the relays to come.
Well, we are underway in the 1 meter diving, and we bring in our diving expert, Pac-12 champion, Natalie Kalibat. Now we are on the third, now Florida Atlantic's Selena Stoddenhertz.
Selena doing a nice job to start her competition with a foot-first entry. You'll see these on the one-meter springboard. She did a really good job going in clean in the water. Diving is all about the takeoffs, the positioning in the air, and then finding that crisp, clean entry.
Frida Zuniga Guzman, I thought she was really good in the prelims and ended up finishing fifth, the sophomore, with her first dive here in the finals.
John, Frida is excellent. Her coach calling her a next level kid. She's an international phenom, and she is just such a good diver. Taking a look heading into the finals tonight, Paige Burrell, she set that new record. A lot of momentum there. You've got the defending champion, Nicole Stambo of SMU in there. And Frida, who you just saw dove, she earned top eight spots in all three events last year. So a lot of stiff competition on the diving side.
It's going to be a lot of fun to watch as we get a chance to see Nicole Stambo. She's the defending champ in this event.
Yeah, you have to wonder, home pool advantage. I talked to her coach, Darian Schmidt, and he mentioned that it is a little bit comforting that the women get to dive on their own boards, in their own pool, and the familiarity, of course, with the spots that the divers are always looking for.
Now bringing in Jacqueline Fowler, who is third in the prelims.
This is the first year we have official neutral judges. I sat down with the head judge, Emily Richmond. She gave us some really good insight that you guys will hear later. And she talked all about what they're looking for. And that's a huge step in the right direction with the neutral judging. It's huge.
Alicia Mora, second in the prelims. Her first dive.
Brings back so many memories just being in the finals, just having to keep your composure, your poise. Alicia did a great job in the prelims, and she set the tone early so far here in the finals tonight.
44 on that dive. And now here's Paige Burrell, who set a meet record with that 316.9. She made it to the NCAA championships in the 1 meter last year at UNC. It's got to give her a ton of confidence.
Got a ton of confidence, but she's also got the target on her back. And I think she's doing a good job of keeping her composure and taking it one dive at a time. That's all you can do, right, John?
Exactly. And so beginning round number two now, after the first eight have gone, Paige Burrell of FIU leads after the first round with a 53.3. So picking up where she left off. Jessica Lopez of ECU.
Yexa Lopez and Frida on ECU. I talked to their coach. He mentioned that they speak Spanish to each other on the pool deck. Their other teammates are trying to learn the language. They're trying to help them, and they're definitely two leaders on the East Carolina program.
Richard Kerbeck had a 49.4, was second through the first turn.
Nice takeoff. I have to say all the women so far in the finals have just done a really nice job of going after their dives, taking time on the start to get the most out of the diving board.
Selena Stoddenhurst back in. Stoddenhurst second to last in the initial dive with a 44.85. We'll see what the FAU senior has for the second time.
Did a nice job of keeping her hips up on the diving board. That's what you want to do for inwards, get that nice balance of not being too far from the board, but also keeping it a nice distance.
And moving on to Frida Zuniga Guzman of ECU, just a sophomore. Guzman with a 46.8 on her initial dive.
Just knows how to stop the dive. And when I mentioned that on this back one and a half, she had so much power off the diving board that her legs almost washed past vertical, but she was able to pike save and stop that dive.
The first of two consecutive SMU divers, Nicole Stambo, attempting a dive with a difficulty of 2.6 here.
So much poise from Nicole. DD is a big strength of hers. She's got really high degree of difficulty. She does hard dives. She does them well. And she's a defending champion for a reason.
And that dive moves her at least now into first. Here's her teammate, Jacqueline Fowler, the senior.
A lot of the women are doing the same dives, and you'll see them back to back too. The women do six dives, one in each category, front, back, reverse, inward, twister, and they double up on a group. Just personal preference.
It's a really big number of 48.3 there for Fowler. Alicia Mora now from Florida Atlantic.
Gorgeous top. Got a lot of height off the springboard. Springboard is aluminum, so you want to try and find that rhythm and get the most out of it. She did a really nice job, Mora, with that takeoff and then finding the bottom.
It's a 53.3 there, and Alicia Mora moves into first place, 97.3 for the two dives. And now there's Florida International's Paige Burrell, 53.3 on her opening dive.
Incredible power that Paige has. And she actually competed, and she was a champion on the trampoline, and she was also a former gymnast. So a lot of those techniques and fundamentals in gymnastics and trampoline are transferring over so beautifully in her diving, and I know she's worked very hard.
Back to Jessica Lopez, the freshman from Mexico, a National Youth Group A gold medalist synchro platform in Mexico.
Yexa and Frida actually came from the same pool in Mexico. So they dove with different coaches, but they were in the same pool. So a lot of familiarity there. And they both competed in the Pan Ams and have just done a fantastic job internationally as well.
Bridget Kerbeck of North Texas had a great first dive. Second dive left a little bit to be desired. She's in sixth right now, heading into this third dive.
A lot of times the back and the reverse category will be the name of the game for a lot of the women competing. If you want to hit those dives, for some reason they're a group that might cause a little bit more effort in that category.
Here's Selena Stottenhertz from Florida Atlantic. She was sixth in the prelims.
See, her entries are just, she's so clean, follows through on the lineup, does a great job of just slicing through the water.
Moves her ahead of Kerbeck, but behind Lopez. And here's ECU's Frida Zuniga Guzman.
A
looking to move her way up. Right now, she is in eighth place out of the eight divers.
Beautiful top. Gets all the air off the springboard. Folds into the pike. You see, look at the height she gets off the springboard. Tiny pike. Lines it up and just disappears in the water. What a beautiful dive from Frida.
And the 48 moves her into first place. And so that was a really good game-changing dive there by Zuniga Guzman. Back to the SMU divers and Nicole Stambo.
John, there's just so much talent on the diving boards right now. It is anyone's game. We saw a little bit of a change in the leaderboard in prelims. We're seeing that again in the finals. It's just who can consistently hit every dive.
Now Jacqueline Fowler for SMU. She's been to the national championships when she was at Minnesota back in 2020.
Another really nice reverse one off pike. Gets into that tiny, tight pike, unfolds just beautifully, lines the dive up on 1 meter. You have the least amount of time to complete these dives, and these women are executing these dives with plenty of time and room to kick out.
So that moves Fowler ahead of Stambo with Mora and Burrell to go. Here's Alicia Mora.
Alicia Mora actually jumped into first in the last round. So she's been slowly climbing up the leaderboard. Mora has done a really great job with her consistency and just putting together a really, really nice group of dives.
So she's only behind Fowler at this point. It's Fowler, Mora, Stambo with only Burrell to go. Burrell to go here in round number three as we're coming to the halfway point.
Another really nice dive from Paige Burrell. I talked to her coach after prelims. He was ecstatic about the new record, and he mentioned, take a look at this tight pike. She gets so much height. Pikes out of the dive with a clean finish. She may be doing a forward 3.5 that we'll see later on in this finals. That's a very high degree of difficulty dive.
We move on to round number four. Starting with Jessica Lopez from ECU again.
Really nice display of exactly where you want to place the inward. Finding that balance of being that right distance and showing the control that the judges are looking for.
Now Bridget Kerbeck trying to move her way out of the bottom here from the University of North Texas.
You'll see that back-to-back dive again, really nicely done. It's her fifth year. Coach is grateful she decided to stay. She's a great team leader. Certainly going to be an emotional conference championship for her, that's for sure.
Back to Selena Staudenhurst. For her first three, she's assembled 131 and a quarter points.
Entries, I am blown away tonight. These women are putting on a show. The pressure means absolutely nothing. Take a look at this. Top folds into the pike and just squeezes and stretches, stops the dive underwater with no splash.
That was a 46.
Frida is just so focused and so consistent on all of her dives. She is just so much fun to watch.
So now we're halfway through this fourth rotation. Back to Nicole Stambo, last year's champion. Stambo in fourth after the first three dives.
Job well done. Just a hair past vertical. And when I say that, I mean a lot of the divers want to go straight up and down the water on the backs and the reverses. It almost folds nicely going into the water a little bit past vertical.
Now Jacqueline Fowler, who is our leader through three.
Puts this dive away. Her coach, Darian Schmidt, telling me she's battled adversity. 1 meter is her strength. She's qualified for zones. He's just so excited to work with her each and every day in the pool.
She's back in front with Alicia Mora and Paige Burrell to go. Alicia Mora from Florida Atlantic.
The consistency has just been key. It is unbelievable how focused these divers are with the pressure, especially Paige Burrell. She knows she's got the target on her back. The leader heading in, set a new record. She's just cool, calm, and collect. Burrell has big dives. She's got high degree of difficulty on springboard. So much height, a tight twist, squares out. She just is so commanding in her presence on the diving board.
And that was a big dive because it moves her into first place here at 190.3 with four dives in now over Jacqueline Fowler and Alicia Mora. Right back to Jessica Lopez.
Just super consistent. Lopez has just been putting her dives away and doing such a good job this entire contest.
Bridget Kerbeck. 171.25 through the first four dives. This is her fifth of six dives. This is 2.6 on the degree of difficulty.
This is a hard dive to complete on 1 meter. It's all about the patience in the hurdle. It's a big dive, so you almost want to rush and get there, but you can't. You have to be patient. She does a great job of displaying that.
It's up a 44-2. Now Selena Stadenhurst.
These degrees of difficulty that I talk about, it's endless how high DD you can have. It's incredible to see these dive lists. I mean, you're seeing 2.5s done inward, back, forward 3.5s on 1 meter for the women. It's just amazing how the sport continues to evolve and just get even better.
Now Frida Zuniga Guzman. She was able to move herself ahead of Nicole Stambo after four. Now looking to deliver here on her fifth dive.
These dives are an example as to why she placed in the top eight in all events last year. Patient on the start, tight twist, squares out on the bottom, lines it up exactly what the judges are looking for, that control on twisters.
Didn't quite get the score she was wanting, a touch shy of 39. Here's Nicole Stambo.
Nicole was a little bit back on the board on this takeoff, and sometimes that's hard to adjust in the air. The divers have, okay, plan A, okay, plan B, plan C. You can see her feet don't quite get to the end of the springboard. She still does a good job of getting the dive in the air, but just can't quite control the bottom, letting her legs float past vertical.
And she can't overtake Zuna Guzman. Here's Jacqueline Fowler.
Fowler's a force to be reckoned with. Just, you see, she comes right out, and she's smiling. She's super pumped about that dive.
And she's able to move into first.
Good hurdle, tight pike. She keeps her head up, squares out of the dive.
Alicia Mora now.
Oh, I love this takeoff. Alicia Mora, what a beautiful dive. Keeps those shoulders over the start. You hear a rip entry on the bottom. That's that noise when your hands are together and they hit the water. You watch her shoulders on the start. She stays over the board. Really tight pike and just disappears under the water. Job well done.
Pardon me. 50.4 charges past Fowler by 10 points. And now Paige Burrell of FIU trying to stay in front. She was in front after the fourth dive. This is a 3.1 degree of difficulty dive for Paige Burrell.
Yeah, high DD dive. Paige qualified for the last Olympic trials, earned a spot for this year's trials. Strong takeoff keeps the chest over, just lets the legs past vertical a little bit. We know Paige can do it even better than that. You can see it in her face a little bit.
So as we head into the sixth round, Alicia Mora of FAU is slightly ahead of Paige Burrell, 236.95 to 236.80. Go back to Yasuko Lopez. Right now she is an eighth.
All these divers contributing big points in the point standings. I know we'll be showing that leaderboard throughout this contest, and all these points count so much in the big picture.
Big smile on Bridget Kerbeck's face. She qualified in a tie for seventh. Right now she's in sixth, heading into her final dive of this final.
You could see she wasn't quite happy with that hurdle. I could tell by her body language on the end of the board. But she did a good job of making up for it in the air. You can see she gets a little bit off balance on the end. You can see her arm kind of twisted. Does a good job putting the dive away.
Salita Staudenhurst was in seventh heading into this final dive.
A lower degree of difficulty dive, but done very well. The judges score all these dives based on the start and the finish. She did a good job of putting this dive away from start. Good takeoff. A lot of power, squares it out beautifully.
She'll finish no worse than sixth. So we go to Frida Zuniga Guzman. She's in fourth right now.
Really nice dive for Frida. Her twisters are so square. She gets a good takeoff, squares it out on the bottom, just loses her feet a little bit when she hits the water, just a hair.
Goes past Staudenhurst. Right now she would be in fifth if everyone passes her, but Nicole Stambo was behind her heading into this dive. We'll see.
Hard dive to complete. Nicole does a great job executing this one, making it look easy. Patient on the hurdle, gets her arms all the way through, squares it out. That is muscle memory and pure training, John, right there.
Big number, 49-4, and so she vaults up past Frida Zuniga Guzman by a good 11 points as Jacqueline Fowler comes in.
Fowler just continuing to impress with the pressure. She has beautiful toe point and lines. She's long. And this dive just displays it so beautifully. Folds into the pike, squares out, and look at this entry. It's like a pin drop.
A 54, and she has put herself on the medal stand at least. Now we're down to Alicia Mora and Paige Burrell. Mora was in first heading into this dive.
It's all about the finish. Putting your best dive last. A lot of these divers want to finish with confidence. Really solid finish.
And Mora ends up with a 42.5, and she is just below Jacqueline Fowler. So Fowler in first, Mora in second, Stambo in third, and now it's in the hands of Paige Burrell. DD of 2.4, what are you looking for here?
Gosh, Paige just remaining calm. Just do the dive how you know how to do it. You know, hips up, line it down.
She needs a round of 44 to win.
Does a nice job putting this dive away. Paige handling the pressure.
She's done it. 46.8.
Stays together on the start, lines the dive up, and Paige Burrell dominates here on the 1 meter. Set the tone in prelims, setting a new record. There's a big hug from her coach, Josh Larkham. Paige Burrell gets it done.
Wasn't quite the 316.9. Like you said, she got the job done. The graduate just staying calm and within herself, going back and forth the entire competition, and just edges out Jacqueline Fowler in the end. What did you think about the competition and how it came down, especially those final few dives?
How Paige kept her composure throughout the entire competition and just didn't let nerves get to her. You know, coming in, setting a new record, and then having to continue that dominance and not let the pressure bother you. I think she did a great job just putting all of her dives together and doing such a beautiful job.
And it continues to be FIU's day. They won the 200 medley relay by a whisker. And now Paige Burrell takes the 1 meter finals. As we take a look at the medal stand, Paige Burrell with the 283.6. Jacqueline Fowler, 280.5. She had that huge dive on her sixth dive to finish with silver. And then Alicia Mora from Florida Atlantic finishing in third.
Yeah, FIU, SMU, FAU, all on the podium here. These divers, and actually all the divers in the finals, contributing so many points, and it just makes it so much fun. I know it's the emotion, the adrenaline, the excitement, you know, being under the lights, as you can say, because finals are always at night. These divers just doing such a good job, all of them, keeping their composure, remaining calm, and just executing their dives, taking it one dive at a time, because that's all you can do. Can't focus on anything else but each dive.
So FIU has won the initial swimming event, and then Paige Burrell brings home gold in the 1 meter diving event as well. Paige Burrell setting a record in the prelims and getting it done in the finals. More next. American Women's Swimming and Diving Championships in Dallas. Had some great action so far. FIU to the top of the podium on the first two events, and we just watched Florida International's outstanding diver in Paige Burrell put on a clinic, a show. The graduate out of Lansdale, Pennsylvania, with a clutch dive right at the end of 46.8 on her 2.4 DD dive, and that sixth dive to make it just past a surging SMU Mustang in Jacqueline Fowler and win the diving competition. And let's go ahead and throw it to our public address announcer with our podium announcements.
Direct your attention over the awards podium. We're going to recognize our top ladies in the Women's 1 Meter Championship. It was an 8th place finish for Jetsa Lopez. 7th place for Bridget Kerbeck. 6th place for Selena Stoutenhurst. 5th place for Freda Zuniga Guzman. 4th place for Nicole Stambo. And now your top three ladies in the 1 meter championship. With a final score 279-45, a bronze medal for Florida Atlantic's Alicia Mora. With a final score 280.50, silver for SMU's Jacqueline Fowler. And she set the meet record in prelims this morning with a 316.90. And with a final score tonight of 283.60, your 2024 champion and gold medalist from Florida International, Paige Burrell.
Burrell's best finish ever in a conference championship meet. She did have the bronze in the ACC championships. Remember, she dove for North Carolina before. That was back in 2021. And last year qualified for the NCAA championships in the 1 meter dive. But this season she stands alone at the top of the podium. I'd say the transfer from North Carolina to Florida International has worked out for Paige Burrell as the Panther ends up on top, with SMU second, Florida Atlantic in third. Let's throw it down to Natalie Kalibat with our winner.
Paige, you head into finals, you set the meet record, you keep your composure, and you win it all. How were you able to get that done?
Well, I was definitely very nervous, I'm not going to lie. It was very fast-paced, so I was just trying to breathe and take my time as much as I could. And, yeah, just having fun, too, really helped.
The entire swim team was next to you on the 1 meter, cheering and supporting you. How much does that support mean to you?
It means the world, truly. Yeah, having them here, having my back, just hearing them calmed me down a lot. So I really appreciate it.
You turn your attention to 3 meter tomorrow. What's your focus?
Again, just having fun. It's my last conference, so I'm really excited to just go out there and do my best. So, yeah.
Congratulations on a beautiful performance, Paige.
Thank you so much.
Back to you guys.
It helps you sleep a lot better with that gold around your neck and gives you a lot of confidence heading into tomorrow's diving events as well. And like Natalie said, the 3 meter diving will be a part of a longer third session here at the American Athletic Conference Championships tomorrow night, where our coverage starts at 6 o'clock. On the other side, we've got the 4x200-yard freestyle relay. FIU, again, is the favorite. Can they make it a sweep on the opening night? We'll find out on the other side. And we go into the 800-yard freestyle relay. Here are the lane assignments. North Texas, Florida Atlantic, Rice, Florida International, East Carolina, SMU, and Tulane. What are we looking for in this one, Smacker?
FIU is the defending champion and won the first event and second event, the first diving event of the meet. So right now they're the team to beat. Christy Chewy leading off. She was a part of their 200 medley relay earlier.
FIU's time was about 5 seconds better than anybody else in this league during the regular season with a 7:16.51. And let's meet the competitors on this first leg of the relay. On the bottom, for North Texas, Noelle Marsh, Dolores Margini in the second lane. Third lane is Rice's Amelia Kane. FIU's Christy Chewy, as you mentioned, in that top lane at four. Got Emily Hamlin at East Carolina, an outstanding swimmer in lane five. In lane six, it's SMU's Lucrecia Napolitano. And then two lanes, Victoria Raymond at the top of your screen, the freshman. And early on, it is FIU and Christy Chewy touching the wall first. Remember, it's eight lengths, the 25-yard pool here at SMU for each of the competitors. FIU still in front, but you see at the top of your screen, it looks like Tulane's Victoria Raymond is putting together a really nice first leg as well.
Strong so far in the outside lane and Christy Chewy in the middle. This is a strong event in the sense that it goes a long ways from top to bottom. So you're probably going to lead off with your second best 200 freestyler. And then after that, you're less favorable links are going to be in the middle, and then you're going to likely anchor with your fastest person. Right now, we're about to start the second leg of the relay, and we'll meet these ladies coming up.
Harley Courtois Davies for FIU is in the pool first, the sophomore. And again, for North Texas, it's Kaylee Turner in lane one, Kasia Sleck for Florida Atlantic in lane two, Rice's Shannon Campbell in lane three. Skipping over FIU, it's East Carolina's Carly Clements, a freshman in lane five. Lane six is Indra Vandenbush for SMU. And then Andrea Zibi for Tulane at the top of your screen in lane number seven. But again, FIU getting it done so far. There's Harley Courtois Davies with the kick turn.
This is one of the more fun relays as far as lead changes, because you can have a larger discrepancy between each leg, where if it's a 50 per person, you're not going to see as much movement. But on this relay, you can see the time and which teams are gaining on one another. So FIU has been strong so far. This is a true mid-distance relay. You're going to have a dominant sprinter come up to the 800 medley. You know, a dominant 50 freestyler can do a good 200. And you can also have a dominant distance girl come down to the 200. So depending on who you talk to, the 200 can be anywhere from a sprint to a true, like, this is long. So for me, it would have been a sprint. And it can absolutely be considered that. But it is also a long sprint. So you have to be very careful about how you pace yourself on this event.
That's Smacker Miles, former University of Texas swimmer. And there's FIU's next. That's Nicole Frank Rodriguez, ready for Harley Courtois Davies to come in and touch the wall. And Nicole Frank Rodriguez into the water as FIU continues to lead this event, the 4x2, the 800 freestyle relay, and continuing to widen that lead as well. But in second place, it looks as though SMU right now has overtaken Tulane. The top of your screen, SMU's Isabella Bedoya, a freshman, in just ahead of Sydney Mullen, a sophomore for Tulane. The rest
of the pool. North Texas is Paula Nunez in lane one. Lane two is Florida Atlantic's Maggie Casey. Rice's Elizabeth Myers, a senior, is in lane number three. And like we said, Nicole Frank Rodriguez is way ahead of the pack right now for FIU, right next to East Carolina's Sadie Covington, the sophomore, in lane number five.
Her stroke is really smooth. You see how big her kick is for it being a 200 out in front. And she also has clear water in front of her.
Continuing to edge the lead out, the FIU Panthers. One more up and back for Nicole Frank Rodriguez as we cross the five-minute mark. And FIU is out in front. That last split time was a touch under 28 seconds for Florida International. Meanwhile, for Rice, Elizabeth Myers put together a sub-28 on her last 25 yards, and she is now in second place. But it is FIU's to lose. Anna Luisa Desson is in the water. FIU has a huge lead. You see that Rice now in lane number three. Lily Kramer, the sophomore, trying to put some pressure on FIU.
FIU's third leg tells the story as far as how strong they are depth-wise. Her stroke, you don't even need to see her time to know that that being the stroke of the third leg is going to be a winner.
Anna Luisa Desson way out in front, but you see SMU now falling back a little bit to Rice. Lily Kramer, the sophomore for Rice, now making that turn. And it looks like SMU in third. They're in lane number six at this point. The Florida International, they won the medley relay earlier, and now a dominant effort so far in the 4x2 freestyle. Anna Luisa Desson. Now pretty much feels like she's racing against the clock at this point. Meanwhile, we do have a really good battle for second place as well going right now between SMU and Rice. Rice at the bottom of your screen, touching the wall slightly in front of SMU's Jenna Watson.
You can tell what events the person swims based on their stroke. Right now, in the middle of the pool, you're seeing a true distance stroke. She breathes every other. She's getting a lot of air. It allows her to keep her kick up the entire 200. She's smooth and strong in her kick.
And coming to the wall in a time of 7:09.88, unofficially, FIU wins. Second place is going to go to Rice, unofficially, at 7:15.79, and SMU unofficially in third at 7:17.06. What a dominant effort in the 800-yard freestyle relay. It is FIU's night on the opening night of the American Athletic Conference Swimming and Diving Championships.
Unbelievable start for FIU, showing why they were picked to win the meet going in by the coaches. 3 for 3 on the night, building a sizable lead as quickly as you possibly can. And another strong start for Rice. They bounced back in that relay after getting DQ'd in the first relay. And we knew they had an outstanding distance crew, but to be so sharp off the blocks in the first event, even with the DQ, is a good sign for their weekend. And then rounding out the podium is SMU. They are strong across the board, solid mid-distance group, and it showed on that relay.
The times for FIU about almost 7 seconds better than their season best. And so, as you mentioned, that tapering that these swimmers do pays big dividends for FIU. And Florida International looks ready to go on all accounts here in Dallas.
I wish that everyone could experience taper for once in their life. It's the best feeling in the world. Training gets easier, you get happier, you have more time to sleep, and you focus on all of the work that you've put in as opposed to the current work. You sharpen up turns and starts, and then you feel like you're floating. It's just a completely different feeling once you've stopped all the heavy weight training. You feel so good in the water. You feel like you're just gliding across effortlessly compared to some of the training moments being very tough.
Well, it has been an exciting first night. A lot of energy here on the deck. And FIU, the favorite, shaves 7 seconds off their season best time to win the 800 freestyle. The podium next. Welcome back into Dallas. The American Women's Swimming and Diving Championships here at Robson and Lindley Aquatic Center in Dallas. I'm John Liddle, back alongside Smacker Miles and Natalie Kalibat. All over but the podium here on night number one. And here are your results as we have them. As we said, Florida International in a shade under 7:10. Rice in 7:16. That was a season best for Rice by about 9 seconds. And then you've got SMU at 7:17 as well. All these teams peaking at the right time. But it's Florida International again. They're going to be sleeping well, feeling good, heading into day two.
Yeah, winning the 800 free relay by that much is a good indicator you're going to win the 400 free relay. Mm. Not necessarily an indicator of the 200 free relay, but their sprint relay, even though it was the medley, is a good indicator of that. They won 4 of 5 relays last year, so they are being predictable in a great sense if you're the FIU Panthers. And then second, with Rice, I think that's a little bit of a surprise. They've had a good season, but like you mentioned, peaking at the right time. And a good indicator for their meet to come and how good their mid-distance team is.
We're waiting on the splits, but it seemed as though it was that third leg of Elizabeth Myers for Rice that really helped them get past SMU and into second place on the podium.
Rice is known for their distance swimming, so it's not necessarily a surprise, but still really impressive to put together 4 such strong 200 free events to put it together for the relay, and that's the event that they would be most favored in as far as the relays, but they could also shine in the 400.
Randy Horner told us, I'm not sure there's an event that I don't think we can't win. That's a double negative, so I guess he was saying that he thought they could win every event, and he's been right so far.
Double negative that has been fact to this point.
It certainly has. Their season goal, their challenge, it was 4-1. They wanted to win here, and so far they are really making a statement. So, for the SMU Mustangs, they finish in third as we go to the podium.
With a final time of 7:15.79, silver for Rice University.
So SMU still making their way over. Rice needs to do.
The bowl games, the players bring their phones onto the stage.
Yes.
Now. I'm surprised we haven't seen that yet in swimming for the podium selfies.
7:09.88. Your 2024 champions, gold medal for Christy Chewy, Arlie Corthoys Davies, Nicole Frank Rodriguez, and Anna Luisa Dyson, Florida International.
Congratulations to Florida International. They are your champions in the 800 freestyle relay this evening. FIU, 3 straight here on the opening night. SMU finishes with the bronze. And Rice with the silver as well this evening in the 800 free. But Randy Horner told us that our whole goal as a team has been 4-1. Like, everything they have done has been directed toward the American Athletic Conference Championships. They're so used to winning Conference USA, but they finished second last year to Houston. They wanted to be in that number one spot, and what a start to the meet so far for Florida International.
Growing up in club swimming, you chase time standards and rankings, and it's all very individual, and you're trying to make the fastest meets and the fastest heats and finals of the fastest meets, but it's all for you. And when you get to college and it's finally about the team, it's so much more fun. So we're getting to see that in full force tonight.
After taking a little bit of time, now the medals for the SMU Mustangs, who finished with the bronze, and it'll be Rice again with the silver. It's a good bounce back for Rice, considering they were DQ'd in the medley relay.
That's all you can do if you're the Rice Owls, and good for them for bouncing back so well and getting the silver in the next event, in the next swimming event, in the next relay. And that says everything you need to know about how they'll move forward in this meet.
And I don't mean to be obvious man of obviousness here, but, you know, if you're Rice, you know, it points-wise is better to finish seventh than get disqualified. And so that's really going to hurt a team that probably felt like they had a shot coming into the week. Is there anything they can do? Can they come back from that?
I know. The scratch is just like insult to injury. Like, not only does it drop you to eighth, it actually takes away points in its entirety. And I was an IMer, so it's a very technical event, so it's the same situation. If you mess up, you know, one aspect of it, you're done with it. So that's kind of the essence of relays, and that's why you have safe starts.
But for Rice, they're putting that behind them, and they finished second in this event. Congratulations to the Owls and SMU, but Florida International, again, out top. And Florida International takes all three of the initial offerings here in Dallas. Christy Chewy, Harley Cortoise-Davies, Nicole Frank Rodriguez, and Ana Luisa Desan, your champions on night number one in the 800-yard freestyle relay.
Christy Chewy already with two gold medals in the conference on night one.
Absolutely. What a night for her. What kind of recovery does that take? I know it was a shorter leg to start things out in the medley. However, there's a recovery aspect to get back out there an hour later and do it again. What do you do as a swimmer during that time to make sure you're at your peak?
The key there is swimming tough events generally. So her events are not easy. She's a breaststroker, IMer, mid-distance. She can go up pretty high distance-wise. So she knows what she's doing as far as how far she wants to go between events. So you can either do it based on time or distance. And they actually test you lactic acid-wise on, like, where your optimal cool-down is. And the technology behind it is really fun, and it was a lot of fun to learn about how your body works just to be able to be optimized. But she knows what she's doing with that, and I think for her the biggest thing will be how it plays out over the weekend. So making sure to get enough recovery between prelims and finals, and if she can take it a little bit easy on a prelim, that she's able to do that.
And let's go down to the gold medal winners, FIU, with our Natalie Kalibat.
You guys came in as the defending champion, and you win with a personal best in this event. How were you able to get it done?
Well, honestly, we put in a lot of work, like, leading up to conference and stuff. Like, we put a lot of hard work in practice. We got a team behind us supporting. The parents are here supporting us as well. And we all know that no matter what, the team's going to be proud of us of what we do. Just go in with an empty mind. I know the three of them were really nervous, but, like, they put that aside and just did what they had to do. And, yeah.
In the overall points race, day one, you win two relays and the 1 meter diving. How much momentum does this give you guys?
I think this will be a boost of confidence for us, like, the whole team, that we're getting off to a good start. And knowing that we started the day well would definitely help us going through the next 3 days.
What is the message that coach is giving you guys heading into this conference championship?
Well, definitely each of us had different messages from the coaches. For me, it was, like, coach said, like, just go in there and do what you gotta do. Like, we're all fit. We've put in the hard work. You've got good practices. Like, we all know what to do. Just go and get the work done, and no matter what, the team's going to be proud of you.
Message to you. They just told us that we're not swimming like alone. We're always swimming for the team, and I feel like that really helps. So you know you have the team. The team got you.
Yeah, I think it's a little summary of that too. Coach before the race told me to enjoy because he knows I get stressed really easily. So I think that was like what was in my mind during the race. I was just enjoying for me and for them and for the whole team because I think we just came to fight and show what we can do. Yeah, I think for me, I was freaking out before this one. I was super nervous, but Brian just told me this is so cool. You only get to do it 4 times and it's an awesome environment to be in. So just make the most of it.
Congratulations, ladies.
Thank you.
John, back to you.
Congratulations to FIU. Here's tomorrow's event schedule. We'll start out with the 500-yard freestyle, follow that up with the 200-yard individual medley, followed by a big-time sprint, the 50-yard freestyle. Blink, and you will miss it. We'll take a breath with the 3-meter diving, and then the 200-yard freestyle relay, a high-energy event to finish out day number two. What should we know about day number two, Smacker?
Every time I look at the event order, I'm like, oh, that's my favorite day. I love that day. I love watching the 200 IM, the sprint IM. That was my event. And 500, the tough event, but you get dizzy, and there's a lot to fight for and a lot of lead changes there. 50 free, of course, slash and dash, a lot of fun to watch. 3-meter diving is exciting, and closing out with the true sprint relay.
We'll be on the air at 6 o'clock Central Time tomorrow night. And so for Natalie Kalibat, Smacker Miles, and our entire ESPN crew, this is John Liddle from Dallas saying so long. Remember, yeah, join us tomorrow. We've also got the prelims coming up at 12:30 Eastern Time tomorrow. You can find all these events on the ESPN app. This has been a presentation of the American Athletic Conference and ESPN.